once again in the glow of the atom.
Thank you. What comes after the end? I don't know. Neither did they. They were just an army engineer battalion, constructing roads and bridges deep in the middle of the Arizona nowhere. They didn't know why Armageddon had come. They'd heard radio chatter about an attack on some space-based missile platform. But who had attacked it, or why? No one knew. What they did know is that the politicians and the generals had finally ended the world. Now, everything was gone. They took over a federal prison for a fort, kicked out the convicts, got busy starting from scratch. Maybe it was an act of mercy. Maybe they figured that the prisoners would die out in the harsh new world. Whichever, it came back to bite the engineers in the ass. Cultists, criminals, cannibals. They've been living with the fallout ever since. Good people had survived too, called for help in the night. And those engineers, those common soldiers, could not stand by and see them die. So they came out of their fort, and they helped the survivors defend their homes. And for that, they earned a new name, a proud name, the Desert Rangers. Now, Rangers, I know at times it seems our cause is hopeless. And I know it's hard to say goodbye to a brother in arms. But I want you to know something else. That no Ranger who dies in the line of duty will ever be forgotten. Nor will he have ever died in vain or unavenged. Thank you, recruits. I appreciate you coming to Captain Ace's retirement party when you hardly knew the man. Appropriate, too, seeing as how investigating his death will be your first duty as a Desert Ranger. Ace had been trying to locate a faint radio signal, which has lately been giving us cause for concern. We gave him 3 repeater units and sent him to hook him up to 3 remote radio towers. This would have allowed us to get a fix on the signal. But sadly, Ace was murdered by unknown assailants right after hooking up the first tower, and his logbook and the last 2 repeater units were stolen. The voice on those broadcasts disturbed me greatly. It talked crazy talk about a future where man and machine would be one. Worse, it talked about us, the Desert Rangers, specifically. It said it was coming for us. When you get back to the Citadel, talk to our radio expert, Wade Woodson, if you want to know more about the technical details. All I know is the repeaters will upgrade the towers and allow us to zero in on the mystery signal. I'll give you the locations of the towers once you have the repeaters in hand. More important to find them first. Don't know, but it wasn't on Ace's person when he was found. Look for it. It might have some clues as to his death. Yeah, I know. You've hardly found your feet with us, and here I am sending you on a mission that already got one Ranger killed. Well, I wish I had another option, but the Desert Rangers are spread a little thin right now. Ranger teams Abel and Charlie are out west trying to stop a range war out there from becoming straight-up genocide, and Team Baker is up north looking for a way through the radiation that's cut us off from Vegas. I'm afraid the next generation is going to have to lead the charge on this one. The mission is this: search the area where Ace's body was found and do your best to recover his logbook and the repeater units. Then call in your report. If you find the repeaters, I may send you on to finish his mission. Ace's death must be avenged, and it will be. But finding the signal he died trying to track down is just as important. Besides, I got the sneaking suspicion that when you find the one, you'll find the other. It's about a day's walk east from here. I'll mark it on your map. There you go. Yes, call in on your radio. Your radio is your lifeline to Ranger Citadel. We'll be calling you with alerts and updates on your current missions and sending you new missions when we receive distress calls. As Rangers, it is your sworn duty to respond to those calls. That is the contract we made with the people of Arizona when we opened for business. Once you prove yourself, the Citadel will be your new home. Consider this mission the final test of your training. If you succeed, you are welcome within our walls. If you fail, then you aren't cut out to be a Desert Ranger, and we won't let you in. The hard-ass approach, huh? Well, you might get what you want from some folks in the Waste through intimidation, but it doesn't always work, particularly with old hard-asses like myself. You want to kick down our doors? Go ahead, give it a try. But I ain't pissing myself just because you growled at me. Good luck out there, recruits. Thank you.
Team Echo, this is Ranger Command. Come in. Roger, Echo One. Just making sure your radio is working. I'll be your dispatcher from here on out. I also wanted to give you a little heads up on your water situation. If you've all got full canteens, you should have enough water to reach the place where Ace died with plenty to spare. But if you're going to go exploring, you'll want to fill up again at any oasis you can find. Remember, your main priority is to recover the repeater units Ace was carrying. Once you've got the devices, you'll be headed to Ag Center and High Pool all them. But we'll talk about that after you acquire the repeaters. We must, of course, bring Ace's killers to justice. But right now, that's secondary to discovering the location of that signal. It is vital that all teams stay in radio contact with me here at the base. We get distress calls from all over our jurisdiction and sometimes beyond. Towns or farms or mines being attacked by raiders, mutant beasts, what have you. We field those calls here and then dispatch whichever team is closest to the problem. Until now, Woodson's been our dispatcher. But Ace's death made me realize I've spent too many years in my office, walled off from the world, how it's changing. I need to know what's going on out there, and I figure the best way to do that is to start listening to the people's problems. Don't let that make you self-conscious or nothing. 10-4, Echo One, carry on. Ranger Command out. Roger that, Echo One. When you reach the area where Ace's body was found, give it a good going over. The folks that picked him up said it looked like he crawled there. Maybe you can find some tracks leading to where he was attacked. Copy? 10-4, Echo One, and check in immediately with any new info. Those repeater units are a top priority. Ranger.
Thank you. let me tell you Matthias's law, friends. Matthias's law is vengeance. And soon, Matthias's law will stretch all the way to Arizona and kill those so-called upholders of justice, the Desert Rangers.
Echo One, this is Ranger Command. Go ahead. Copy, Echo One. Appreciate the update.
Thank you. Thank you.
Echo One, go ahead. Got an update for me? What?
Well, I'll be goddamned. We haven't seen any synthetics around for almost 15 years. We better get a closer look at the tech. Mirror Captain might be able to tell us where it came from. See if you can grab a piece of it and bring it back to Mirror Captain the next time you're at the Citadel.
That is Mirror Captain's fancy word for smart robots. She calls them synthetic life forms, or synths. Basically, any robot that can think for itself falls into the synth category. Plain old robots are dangerous enough. Ones that think for themselves are a nightmare. Good, but our priority is still those repeaters. Now that you have them, I'm sending you on to complete Ace's mission, which was to attach him to the most powerful towers in Arizona so we can get a fix on that mystery signal. One tower is at High Pool, the other is at the Ag Center. Sending you the coordinates now. High Pool is at the most southern and eastern corner of our jurisdiction. They're a vital part of the stable society we've been trying to build here in Arizona. They provide clean water to us and many other communities and farms, maintain an emergency reservoir in case of drought. See Mayor Vikstrom there about using their tower. He knows you're coming. They built their tower on top of an old crane. A bit unorthodox, but it gets great reception. Ag Center is due south of Ranger Citadel and very important to what we're trying to achieve. The researchers there are developing hardier plants and animals that will thrive in the harsh conditions of the waste. If it all pays off, we may see the day when nobody in Arizona goes hungry. Talk to Matt Forrestal about hooking up to their radio dish. He used to be one of us. Now he runs things down there. Matt's good people. He used to be part of an old satellite relay system, from what Woodson told me. Strongest transmitter in Arizona. Roger, Echo One. Ranger Command out.
Yeah.